Hey guys, my name is Maria and I'm your watercolor instructor. In this tutorial, we're going to paint this fall foggy-like landscape. I am going to paint it on Hahnemühle Collection watercolor paper. This is a block cold pressed, 140 pounds, and the size is 9 by 12. So we have like fog in the background, right? And then we have like some of the foliage in the foreground, so which is like richer, and you can definitely see some browns and reds in there. And then we have like in the middle somewhere there, we have the trees. So the trees are definitely going to be pronounced in this painting, but I'm going to start with the first layer. This is going to be about 2-3 layer painting, but the first layer is going to be wet on wet, and I'm going to forget about like the details that I see, like there's a fence and the trees. I'm not going to think about those most pronounced trees, and I'm going to think about all the lightest colors that I see first, basically all that fog, all the fog colors, and I'm going to use for that like blues, some of the yellows, and I see a little bit of brown over the road too, and reds. And at the same time as I am painting this first layer, wet on wet, I am going to paint those trees in the background, and they are inside that fog, so they're out of focus. So that's a perfect way to actually paint those trees wet on wet at the same time. So the first layer is going to be softer, and then once it dries, that's when I can start thinking about that meadow part with those trees in the foreground. And those are the colors that I chose. So this is Schminke Horadam, and I do have like neutral tint for like the darkest tones that I need to include, maybe like a little bit in the foreground. I do want to create a nice contrast. The reference image has a beautiful contrast because we have a lot of light in there overall. Even this is like a foggy grayish landscape. Now for the browns, I like both of these. So this is burnt sienna and this is gold brown. The thing is that they're technically like very similar, so you don't really need two, but one is like warmer and the other one, like the gold brown, is actually more yellowish. I like using both of these. Then Van Dyke brown or sepia is fine. Then I have the burnt umber. This is alizarin crimson. So this is like a darker red, but I want to add it to the foliage, so I'm going to be mixing it with the browns. And then we have a yellow ochre here, so that's also for like the foreground, but I am going to add a little bit of yellow to the sky to create like this blue gray yellow gray sky. And for the sky, I also have Prussian green, and then follow sapphire blue, and then a little bit of indigo here, and then sap green in that middle range over here, but also like here. And a lot of it is going to be basically done with that first layer wet on wet. So I'm going to place these on the side, and the next thing I do, I dilute colors with water, and that's because I am going to paint it wet on wet, so I want my colors to be ready to grab and go. So when I dilute these colors with water, I dilute them into a consistency of heavy cream-like ratio. So think of dairy. That's how I kind of always go about, like how I explain the ratio between water and paint. So I go from like water-like ratio, so the paint is very diluted with water, to milk-like ratio, and then to half and half-like ratio. So think of the creamer for your coffee. Or then we go to the heavy cream-like ratio, so the cream that you would whip it for your heavy cream, right? So heavy cream-like ratio, and that's when I paint wet on wet. So when I paint wet on wet, I go with either half and half-like ratio or heavy cream-like ratio, and then when I go wet and dry, then the ratio is no more than milk-like ratio, because you don't want the paint to be thick when you paint over the dry surface of the paper. So I'm going to place these on the side and then dilute each color with water. So the next step is to wet the entire paper.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.